Hello everyone, welcome to Coders Camp. So today we are going to cover another interesting problem from LeetCode contest, which is splitting a string into descending consecutive values. So here the input given is a string which consists of only digits, and we have to return true if we can possibly split the elements or the numbers in a consecutive descending order. So let's understand this problem with an example first. So here is our given example string 050043. So if you ignore the zeros, in case if you don't want the zeros, and the numbers you can form here is 5, 4 and 3. Here 5, 4 and 3 is a consecutive descending values. That is, the difference between each of the values is 1 and in decreasing order. So this satisfies the actual condition that we can split the string into descending consecutive values. So we have to return true as our output. So how are we going to approach this? Consider the same number 543. Let me add two more numbers to understanding the example. So here is our given string. So if we are considering our first number as 5, in that case, after 5, the second number can be 4 or 43 or 432 and 4321. And again, in the second layer, if you are considering 4 as our second digit or first digit, then in that case, the next digit can be 3 or 32 or 321. So if we consider 432 as our number, then the next value or the next decreasing consecutive value we can consider here from the given string must be 1. Because after 432, the only number left here is 1, so that can be its child. After 4321, there are no children left. So this is for only considering 5 as our first number. What if we consider 54 as our first number? So in that case, again a tree goes in such a way that the second number can be 3 or 32 or 321. Same way, after 32, the second number can be 1, or after 3, the numbers can be 21 or 2. So it goes on again for the value. The first number is 543 and goes on a separate tree for this value. And considering the first number as 5432 and then a tree, and considering the first number itself as 54321 and then a tree. So consider this example. 4321 is the given string, and we have considered 4 as our first number, 43 as our first number, 432 as our first number, and 4321 itself as a first number. So that each of them have their separate trees, and if any of the tree from starting of the given number to end, it satisfies the condition that every level the value is the next decreasing consecutive value. That is, the difference between the parent and the child is going to be 1 at every layer till it completes all the number in the given string. If there exists a path, then which means it is satisfying the condition, then we are going to return true. If not, if no path matches such criteria, then in that case we are going to return false. So this structure resembles nothing but our tree. So we are going to have a tree traversal. So which one to choose, BFS or DFS? So here we want to go deep, that is, we want to go till the last node of a tree to find whether the complete string satisfies the given criteria. So in that case, we obviously gonna do a basic DFS. And in this tree structure, you can have a doubt. That is, if suppose our first number is 4, which is a one digit number. So obviously the next number must be one digit or lesser. Like if it is a two digit number, then the next decreasing number must be two digit or one digit. It cannot be three digit or more than two digits. So in that case, we are also considering a two digit number and a three digit number for its children. That is the next consecutive decreasing number. So why? So in this case, it is invalid, obviously, but consider the string. So if this is our example, our tree is going to have 5 as our parent. In that case, if we have 0, 0, 0 and 0, 0, 0 and finally 0, 0, 0, 4 as our children, as possibly the first three cases are going to be invalid and the fourth case alone is going to be valid as we can ignore the zeros in the front of the number and consider only 4 for our next decreasing number. So to attain these kind of cases, since our input is a string, we are going to explore all digits in our tree. So we are going to perform a recursive DFS solution in order to get the answer for this. So our solution is going to start by having the first character and exploring all possible child for that character. Considering 4, it is going to perform the recursion for all 3, 32 and 321 till it completes the length of the string and checks the condition whether my parent value and current value difference is 1. That is, if I'm calling a recursive function, then my 4 is going to be my parent. And all its possible values are going to be its children or current value. So we are going to check whether parent minus current value is 1. Then we are going to continue in that path. If that is not satisfied, then in that case, we are going to simply ignore those paths at that step itself instead of going till the last node. So once our code moves to 3, and checked whether the difference between 4 and 3, that is parent and current, is 1, in that case, this path is going to be a valid path, or there are chances that this path can be a valid path. So in that case, now our parent shifted to 3 and it generate all possible children of that 3, and they are going to be the current value. And again, it is going to check whether now our current is going to be 2. Now again, it is going to check whether our parent value minus the current value is 1. Then it is going to continue in the same path. So hope you're understanding the solution and understanding what is DFS, because we are going to implement a basic DFS recursive solution here. So let's move on to code now. So yes, as I said, we are going to implement our DFS using a helper method. So I'm going to write helper. And I'm going to start with my given string and my parent as minus 1 because we did not reach our root node yet. So now here in my helper method, so I am declaring the long parent because here in the constraint they have given, the length of the string must be less than or equal to 20. So here the maximum value of an integer in Java is going to be a 10 digit value. So in that case, if our complete string is 20 digit length, then if we convert it, integer is not going to be sufficient. So we are declaring all the values here in long. I'm going to check whether if my string dot length is equal to 0, then return true. Else, I'm going to declare a current variable, which is going to start from 0, and I'm going to iterate my given string. So I'm going to assign my current value as current star 10 plus character at that index. So as the iteration goes, this is going to add or append one character at a time to the current value. So if the example is 4321, then first current is going to be 4, and then 43, and then 432, and so on. Once this is calculated, I'm going to check the basic condition. If my parent value and current value difference is 1, and the rest of the values also should satisfy this condition. So I'm going to call the helper method again recursively by passing the substring from I plus 1. That is its children. If suppose our given input string is 4321, then our current will hold 4 as our current string. Helper is going to call to explore its children. So its children going to start from I plus 1 index, which means 3 and then append 321, 32, 321 and so on. So now our helper will have the substring goes like that, comma. Our parent is going to be our current now because we are going to explore current's children. So yes, if this is the case, then return true. If not, finally return false. So this is it, but we have to check one more condition, that for the first time we are exploring the root node or the first digit in the string. In that case, the difference will not be equal to 1 as that is the first number. So in that case, we have to check whether the difference is equal to 1 if our parent is not equal to minus 1. If parent is not equal to minus 1, then we have to check the difference is 1 and call the function. Also, it will not be satisfied when we reach the leaf node because it doesn't have any children. So in that case also, we don't have to check this condition. So again, I'm going to add one more condition here. That is, if I is not is equal to s dot length, that is string length, and then parent is not is equal to minus 1, in that case, whether parent minus current is equal to 1. So yes, let's run and try. Let's submit. Yes, our solution is accepted and runs in 0 milliseconds. So thanks for watching the video. If you like the video, hit like, subscribe, and let me know in comments. Thank you.